We own a property in Pulaski County, outside of Hawkinsville, Georgia, about 50 miles south of Macon. It's a family farm. We grow a diverse mixture of trees on this property. A forest would be defined by the owner, and that could vary anywhere from a backyard forest to a 10,000-acre forest. The fact that it's growing trees and able to reproduce or be reproduced by replanting, it makes it a forest. The major part of the land I own is classified as a working forest. A working forest is one that needs to pay for itself, and then that process entails the trees growing, and the trees often grow to the point that they compete very seriously with each other. And at that stage, we do what's called a commercial thinning, where we go out and cut some of the diseased trees and some of the trees that are bent or deformed in other ways, and allow the surviving trees to grow faster and in a better form. Eventually, it may be the owner's desire to harvest that tract of timber at the end of 40 years or so. If that's done, then the next step would be to do what's called site prep, where the land is cleared so that a clean slate is there for a new crop of trees to be planted. Georgia grows 48% more trees than we harvest. We're growing more than we're cutting. In the state of Georgia, between 250 and 350 million trees are planted annually. And my little part of that is between 50,000 and 150,000. There are so many benefits that trees provide us. The furniture you sit on is of wood. Musical instruments are made of wood. And beyond that, the pulp that's produced by harvesting pulpwood, smaller diameter trees, creates paper, which is a renewable resource and a biodegradable resource. Water quality from a forest land is immensely more pristine and more easily utilized for drinking water intake, for irrigation purposes, when it is coming off of land that's been in forestry. Forest land acts as a natural sponge for the rainfall that comes down. So it slows it down, it's absorbed into the soil, the trees utilize that water for their growth, and the runoff that does occur is much cleaner as it enters the waterway. The benefits to wildlife are enormous. We have foxes, squirrels, bobwhite quail, snakes, alligators, beavers. The woods themselves are home for wildlife, and we need to recognize that. Just like animals, trees need food to survive. The way trees get that food is through a process called photosynthesis. Photosynthesis requires sunlight, water, carbon dioxide gas, and chlorophyll, which is a substance found in all green plants. Plants take in water from the soil and carbon dioxide from the air. Photosynthesis starts when chlorophyll absorbs energy from the sunlight. Green plants use that light energy to change water and carbon dioxide into oxygen and nutrients called sugars. The oxygen is released into the air, and then we're able to breathe that oxygen. Because trees provide a lot of oxygen for us to breathe, our quality of life would be severely compromised without them. Without trees, life would look a lot different. So it's important to protect forest land, replant trees when they're harvested, and appreciate trees for what they do for us every day.